In today's video, I'm going to be putting the new LG CordZero back to the test and also comparing it to the Dyson V15 and the Roborock. If you guys are like me and kind of nerdy and into cleaning, well, you gotta check out this new LG CordZero all-in-one tower vacuum. It's basically a new cordless stick vac with a base station that not only recharges the vac and elegantly stores the tools hidden away, but it also automatically empties its debris into a larger disposable collection bag. It's a really cool concept with some awesome features, but at $1,000, it's not cheap, and there's a few wishlist items that I found that you should know. Check this out, they include some extra goodies for me, some cereals and candies, some things to make a spill and see how it cleans up. All right, this is gonna be kind of cool. I think this is one of those that you twist and explodes confetti everywhere. It's gonna make a fun mess, and let's see how the vac cleans it up. Oh, and no, this video is not sponsored by LG. They did send me the sample unit for me to keep and play with, and then the Dyson V15. I bought that thing myself, but you guys should know me that just a sample unit's not gonna sway my decision. This thing's $1,000. This thing is $700. I wanna give you my honest thoughts and review. See which one is actually carries more bang for the buck. I am super excited for the auto emptying bin. That thing fills up, it's disgusting to try to empty it, dust everywhere. Now, this thing comes at a premium price tag, but it sure looks and feels premium. Two batteries, double the amount of cleaning time.
Ooh, I like the white, it's pretty cool. Ooh, nice little rubber grippy on the back end. Cleaning mop, that's something I didn't even realize at first, that this thing also is gonna mop. Dang, check that out. The mopping head, that is so sweet.
All right, let's go ahead and unwrap everything and see what's all included, that's a lot. So in all those boxes, there's a lot of stuff. The auto empty tower and vac, telescoping wand, full size and mini power nozzle, combo and crevice tools, two batteries, mopping kit with nozzle, four pads, a spare pre-filter, three dust bags, mounting kit and paper. So no longer needing to tuck the vacuum away in the storage closet or wherever like we do. We hide ours in the laundry room out of sight. It's not super pretty. Something like this, I think we're gonna be able to put it out in the main living dining room area. It's always within reach and it's not an eyesore. It's kind of cool. This is pretty cool. Pull this little latch, opens up the hidden door. Here we've got those bags that we can replace. Push. Drops down, kind of self-closes. You can still see inside through this little window, but it's nothing escaping. That's pretty cool. Little removable filter, it's nice, easy to clean. Ooh, good click. Love that there's no button here that you have to hold like the Dyson. That's one of my biggest complaints. I'm pretty sure it's just a click on, click off. Love that so much better. Ooh, it's quiet. Good suction, but not too loud actually. I think quieter than the Dyson. All right, this is my home office. I purposely haven't sent the robot vac to clean in here for a little bit, so let's go get the vac. All right, here it is. I got it lined up in my cleaning arsenal. All right, fully charged, hasn't really been used yet, so let's go ahead. This will be my first experience cleaning a full room, and I'm excited to see how much it picks up. Let's also run a couple quick time lapses. These are super fun, Insta360 cameras. And I'm gonna try this guy clamping it on. Could be kind of a cool shot. All right, we turn on by pressing the power button. Got a nice little battery indicator. We can go up, high, low. I love that there's no trigger you gotta hold like the stupid Dyson. I hate that feature. This feels way more comfortable. And then if you want turbo, check this out. Hold that for 3 seconds. Woo, you hear that? Baby, we are taking off. There's no LED bar, lights, or anything on the cleaning head, which is really lame. I always like to see something. Even the Dyson had a laser on. It's a hardwood floor cleaner. It's an awesome feature. Also, there's no gate to raise or lower for big chunks or bring it down for extra suction on the carpet. See if it gets that little guy. Oh, struggling to pick up. Did it get it? No. Can't get that little guy. I will say, check out those vacuum lines. Those look really good. All right, so battery just died and I was able to complete the whole room on that max turbo boost. Now, I might be thinking one single battery to do a single room, That's not very good. And it's not, but I don't think I would ever leave on that max boost mode. I don't think it's even meant to be. However, as a positive note, check this out. Right here, lift it up. Bam, a fully charged battery at the ready to have a spare hot swap and then keep on cleaning. That's pretty cool. Boom, battery out. Pop in a new battery. There we go. Click that in. And then boom, that aux battery is charging up. I like having that second spare always on hand. Another cool feature the CordZero has, they call it this compressor tech, whatever. It's basically just this thing that pushes down. I kind of like that. It looks like it cleans off that filter there. And then it compacts it down into that spot. So when it really fills up, you're able to kind of gather a bit more space with that thing. That's cool. So yeah, after cleaning the room, looks like there's actually quite a bit in there. Lots of dust, dirt. All right, now here's the part that I've been waiting for. We've got a bin that's kind of like quarter full, I'll say. Let's go ahead and dock it and see how much sucks out into that self-emptying bin. And we gotta lower this thing down. Don't do it single-handed. You'll just pinch your skin like I did. Here we go. Giving me lots of dings. Oh, check that out. Wow, okay. Let's go into the light. All right, so color me impressed. I thought I was gonna get a lot of big chunks and then leave behind some of the small stuff, but that bin in there, can you guys tell? It looks almost brand new, which, I mean, that's the ideal thing is you just dock it, sucks it out, makes it super clean, even there on the filter, so that each time we go out and do a cleaning, you know that you're getting that most maximum suction cleaning power, which is really cool. Check out this really cool little feature. These things spin in and out. So if you want it just looking nice and clean, minimal, people might even like not even notice it, right? But if you got these little attachments, you just swivel it out on whichever side you want. So this one's here, and then here's the mopping attachment. Check it out, just docks in, super cool. Nice, clean look. All right, now this is a little test. Here's some sticky rice and big chunks. And with the standard roller, let's see how it does. Okay, so it's leaving a little bit of rice behind. Kind of pushing that guy, it's too big.
Yeah, that's great, you kind of need it.
All right, let me show you the Dyson and how it compares. And funny enough, look at how nasty, dirty, filled that is. Who wants to empty that thing? Now, two major comparisons. One, the Dyson has the soft roller brush, whatever you call it. It's made for hard floors and big chunks so that they can hit it, suck right up, and then no problem. All right, works really nice for rice and big stuff like that. And second big difference, this has a gate that opens and closes based upon carpets or hardwood. So you want to leave it open if you're sucking up big chunks, and then you can close it down if you're on the carpets for a more suction seal. With here on the LG, unfortunately, there are no gates, no up, no down. And so when you get those big chunks here on the hardwood, you're just gonna kind of push them around. LG sent over some fun goodies to clean up. All right, this is gonna be the crime scene. Some pillow stuffing, some sprinkles next. Ooh, some cereal. This is kind of scary. All right, guys, we made a big mess. Let's see how the LG vac cleans it up. I just want to do a quick swipe with the Dyson, see if there's any comparison difference. Do you hear that? Give me a little air. I think something got clogged with these long things. Check it out, it's clogged in there. I mean, it was cleaning up everything else really well. Huh. The compressor actually kind of pushes some things out. Not all of it though, there's just too much. All right, a little hiccup there. Things kind of got jammed. Let's do a quick empty test and see if it cleans it out and does a little reset. Looks like it emptied out the bin really well. Now, out of intrigue, let's do a little comparison versus the Dyson and the Roborock. Gotta self-empty this nasty bin. Come shooting back up in your face.
Check it out, look at the Dyson jammed up too. That is hilarious.
Seems like it's the ultimate torture test of confetti like this.
Yesterday it was making that error code.
Oh, something else is jammed in there maybe?
Yeah.
Okay, never mind. This is too funny not to show you guys the actual clog. Can you see it? It's Baby Yoda. Oh, he came out. There it is. The true clog of the Dyson was Baby Yoda. That is hilarious. All right, round two. Next, let's do a quick Roborock test. The one thing I love about the Roborock, actually two things, are the magnetic attachments. Look at that mount, it is so cool. And then this flexible, stretchy hose is really nice for a handheld mode. Bam. Bam, that's pretty cool. All right, we're on boost section, and it also has this sick mode that you can either hold the button or click it over to lock. So you just click it once and it stays on. Oh, it's doing a pretty good job, actually. Oh, that was funny. Shut them all up. And then there's quite a few that shot out when you lift it up. Now let's switch back to the LG boost mode. Ooh, finally got jammed up. It did not like that. But you can compress it back down, that's cool. You can have it automatically empty each time you dock it or just manually start and stop it. It also says empty and replace the bag. Super clean. I'm impressed each time it sucks it all out. It's able to clear it out really well. Here's the bag. I feel like there's still plenty of space left. It's cool, it auto seals it when you take it out. Great for allergies and stuff like that. So you can see in that little window. So in case you have this all sealed up like this, you don't want your dust mites escaping, you can still preview to see how full the bag is and then say, oh, it's not that full. Let's go ahead and put it back in there. Looks like the head width is about the same. Roborock, about the same. All right, and you guys will have to let me know if you wanna see a full in-depth comparison of the LG versus the Roborock versus the Dyson. I think that could be really interesting. All right, let's go ahead and empty the Dyson and just watch how annoying this process is, right? See how you can't push it open until you disconnect this part? It's a little weird. It's got this cool eject button, but it's still, boom. It's still a little bit messy. And then for docking the Dyson, well, it comes with a wall mount, which is nice, and it recharges, but way less elegant than the LG. And then it can hold two little attachments here, but that's basically it. And then any of your others are either on the ground or wall mounted like I did. And let's go ahead and empty the Roborock for comparison's sake. Now, bonus points to the Roborock. You don't have to take off the attachment to empty it, which is a great little touch. Just this little slick button here empties out the bottom. Boom. And then you gotta shake all the goodies out. Sometimes there's things stuck in there, like this is a perfect example. On the LG, it's just gonna suck it all out. And here's the Roborock docking station. Again, I love that it just clicks right in, automatically starts charging. Pretty cool little animation there. And then my favorite part, the magnetic side attachments. And it's both on the left and the right here, which is really slick. You could even snap those to a fridge if you wanted. Or we've got a little after dinner mess. Let's clean it up.
That's not a problem.
Got a charger over there?
Not bad.
It just seems like the front bar kind of pushes the big chunks around. And let's do a quick mopping test. Now what's nice is they include an extra spare set of pads, which is cool. These are just Velcro, they go on and off, easy to wash. Press this little button, releases the tank, you fill it up with, I believe, water only is suggested.
As a funny little glitch, I'd say, the refill port is up at the top, so in a, doing a normal sink, it's not really able to slide under to refill. Not a deal breaker, we got some water in there. Click it back in. And they do suggest to soak these, I believe, with water before putting them on.
Go ahead and Velcro them on.
You can adjust the water output mount, I guess. Low, high, and off. Let's spread a little bit of the coffee they included. Now, it's not gonna be dried or anything, but I'll put some in the grout and see if it's able to clean it up. The plus and minus buttons don't really do anything on here. And unfortunately, there is no vacuuming suction at the same time. I thought it would have been kind of cool if there's maybe a little port that if these things shoot up some small chunkies and debris, it can still go in the canister. Kind of a two-in-one at the same time, but no, it's either one or the other. My favorite feature on here is we have the LED bar. Now, I wish this was on the vacuuming head, but I guess. And of course, the obvious needs to be stated. You kind of have to vacuum first. If there's chunks and debris on the floor, well, it's just gonna kick it around. Here we go. Okay, there we go. Down there in the grout, well, it's kind of harder for it to get in there. And so there's the wet mopping attachment head. Now, it's not super thorough like steam cleaning or anything like that, but I at least appreciate that they include it in the package, and it does an okay job. Now, I understand that this universal power nozzle that was giving me so much trouble with the larger debris and pushing things around and stuff, it's really made for carpets, and LG has this power floor nozzle that's similar to that Dyson laser slim fluffy cleaner head that's made for hard floors. But for this big price tag, I kind of wish LG included that head in the whole bundle. Oh, and how funny is it with Dyson holding that finger trigger? I'm not alone. If you go on Thingiverse, there's a whole list of 3D printed files that you can get. Or here on Amazon, you can even purchase it packaged with this flexible tube. I actually kind of want to try those out. So I love that auto emptying charging tower. I can see the whole industry for these premium vacs moving in that direction. I like how all the tools are hidden away in that modern design. There's no trigger to hold or finger fatigue. You just click the power button on or off. That's how it should be. They include that extra spare battery, plus it charges in the tower. It's a very cool touch. I wish there were LED or lasers or something built into the cleaning head. LG says that the auto emptying disposable bags are good for about 2 to 6 cleanings, depending on how much debris you pick up and stuff. Now, that doesn't seem like a lot. I kind of wish they either had maybe bigger bags in there or maybe a reusable bin. That could be kind of cool option. So there's a lot of neat features with this whole system, but for $1,000, that's a pretty big investment. That Dyson V15 is really cool, but it's still $700. That Roborock is actually a pretty sweet deal for what you get, and it's on sale for only $425. All the links will be down in the description, and again, you guys gotta let me know if you wanna see a side-by-side comparison of all three of them. That could be really interesting. Hope this video was helpful, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.